All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahushai, Ba'ashem Rekakwadash. I want to give double honor to the apostles and great millstone. Shalom to the elect, the teaching word, and all true faith and sincerity. Yeah, man, I just want to title this video, Cleave Unto Wisdom. Because, matter of fact, I'm just going to give a scripture, man. This is Proverbs chapter 4. And verse 13, take fast hold of instruction, let her not go, keep her, for she is thy life. And that's talking about wisdom, man. It said hold fast and take fast hold of instruction, man. It said let her not go, for she is thy life. Well, wisdom, man, that's how you be growing to be kings, man. You know what I mean? Because you hold fast on this wisdom. Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai, not of this world, but Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai, man. You know what I mean? Which is the understanding of these scriptures, man. He said you gotta hold fast on this. Matter of fact, this is Revelation chapter 3 and verse 11. Because I come quickly, behold, I come quickly, hold fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. Yeah, because you got this knowledge. You got the crown, man. You got the kingdom, man. I tell you the whole thing. You got to cling on to it, man. You know what I mean? That no man take your crown, man. You know what I mean? Because it's a spiritual crown, but then second edge is gonna come into play. Second edge, second chance is gonna be a physical crown, man. You know what I mean? You know? But yeah, you got is that. Hold fast with thy head, that knowledge, man. You know what I mean? Hold on to what you got. You know, the Lord gave you them talents. You're going to flip them talents, man. You can't get mad because you only got a certain amount of this. No, man, just do what you got to do. That's your lot. You know what I mean? You know, let's see. Getting to the meat of it. Yeah, this is 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 21. Prove all things, hold fast that which is good. Which is good? The wisdom, man. Knowledge, understanding the wisdom of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai. Knowledge, understanding of the scripture, man. You got to hold on fast to it because this is what's going to keep us going. This keep us going daily, man. Wake up, you think about the scriptures. Yeah, you know I mean, throughout the day, you think about the scripture, tell you seven times a day, I praise thee because of thy righteous judgment. But, yeah, man, that's all day, every day, man. You know what I mean? This is what keep us going. This is what keep us sane, man. Because if we didn't know, man, we'll be a bunch of bugged out niggas, man. You know what I mean? Let's see. Yeah, because when wisdom, man, is grown enough to be kings. If I get that, this is Isaiah 33 and verse 6. And wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times and strength of salvation. The fear of the Lord is his treasure. Yeah, man, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. Even now, man, you know, we're going to need them. We're going to, you know, need it during Jacob's trouble. But even now, man, we need it now. Because all this shit going on, you be, like I said, we'll be a bunch of bugged out niggas, man. Yeah, I mean, but we got this to keep us stable. Yeah, I mean, we stay grounded and rooted in this. This is gonna keep us going, man. But we gotta keep on and hold fast until we got what King David said. As the Lord take not the Holy Spirit away from him, man. Because this is right here, man. This the kingdom right here. The knowledge and understanding of the scriptures, man. Wisdom, you know. But as I said before, man, you know, the Lord gave us his wisdom. Well, he's grooming us to be kings, man. Because every time the Lord, he set up a kingdom, he give them wisdom, man. That's why it tells you in Obadiah, it said wisdom. Matter of fact, let me just get that. I don't want to misquote it. You know what I mean? I know it's in Jeremiah, too. Let me see, I think Jeremiah said too, I believe. See. Yeah, kind of. Matter of fact, yeah, this is Jeremiah 49:7. Concerning Edom, thus said the Lord of hosts, is wisdom no more in Teman? Is their counsel perished from the prudent? Is their wisdom vanished? And yeah, that was the Lord. That's talking about the so-called white man, because you can see, tells you that they are wise in Daniel. But the Lord, the Lord set you up, that means you're going to have wisdom, man. What Jeremiah said, is there no more wisdom in Teman, man? Yeah, you know I mean that wisdom has left them, man. Yeah, you know I mean that lets you know, growing to be kings, you're gonna have wisdom, man. You know, and this is Wisdom of Solomon chapter 6, and verse 21. If your delight be then in thrones and in scepters, O ye kings of the people, honor wisdom that ye may reign forevermore. Yeah, man. So you gotta honor wisdom, man. You desire to be in songs and scepters, man. You want to be a true king. Well, you got honor wisdom, man. You know what I mean? Matter of fact, let me go to chapter 7, man. Wisdom of Solomon 7:8. See, man, you going? It's crazy. You going to Proverbs, Ecclesiastes? Well, there are the whole scriptures wisdom, man. But you know. Wisdom of Solomon, Proverbs, it's talking about wisdom, man. It says her, I prefer her, which, you know what I mean? It's talking about wisdom, man. That's how that's why the Lord tell you, matter of fact, let me just get this, man. You know, so many scriptures, man, about wisdom, you know. Because this, you gotta keep hold to it, man. You know what I mean? Okay, this is, let me get in First Kings. It's First Kings chapter 3. Let me see. Yeah, kind of, this is First Kings chapter 3. Okay, I'm gonna start at 5. First Kings 3:5, and Gibeon the Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream by night, and the Most High said, ask, what shall I give thee? And Solomon said, thou hast shown unto thy servant David my father great mercy, according as he walked before thee in truth and in righteousness and in uprightness of heart with thee, and thou hast kept him for him this great kindness, that thou hast given him a son to sit on his throne as it is this day. And now, Lord, O my power, thou hast made thy servant king instead of David my father. But I am a little child, and I know not how to go out or come in. And thy servant in the midst of thy people, which thou hast chosen, a great people that cannot be numbered nor counted for multitude, give therefore thy servant an understanding heart to judge thy people, that I may discern between good and bad. For who is able to judge that thou so great a people, man? So the Lord asked him, what you want? Solomon said he want wisdom, man. You know what I mean? And look, verse 10, and the speech pleased the Lord that Solomon had asked this thing, and the Most High said unto him, because thou had asked this thing and has not asked for thyself a long life, neither has asked for riches thyself, nor has asked the life of thine enemies, but has asked thyself understanding to discern judgment. Behold, I have done according to thy words. Lo, I have given thee a wise and understanding heart, so that there was none like thee before thee, neither after thee shall any wise like unto thee. That lets you know this. That's Yahweh Shai too, man. Who is wiser than Yahweh Shai, man? You know what I mean? And it says, and I have also given thee that which thou hast not asked, both riches and honor, so that there shall not be any among the kings like unto thee all thy days. Yeah, man. Since you ask wisdom, you're gonna get riches and honor too, man. You know what I mean? I'm gonna read this again. This Wisdom of Solomon 6:21. If your delight be then in scepters and thrones, then thrones and scepters, O ye kings of the people, honor riches, honor wisdom, that ye may reign forevermore. So you wanna be in thrones and scepters, man? Honor wisdom, man. You know what I mean? And I'm going to jump down to Wisdom of Solomon 7:8. I prefer her before scepters and thrones and esteemed riches, and esteemed riches nothing in comparison of her. Yeah, man, it tells you that her price is far above rubies, because you can't buy this, man. At the end of the day, you can't buy this knowledge, man. You can't buy it. And when you buy something, you know, you forcing it. Oh, you can't force this, man, until you can't do 1,000 pushes. You can't read this from cover to cover and read it backwards. Yeah, I mean, and no, man, it got to be given unto you, man. You know what I mean? It says, neither compare I unto her any precious stone, because all gold in respect of her is as little sand, and silver shall be counted as clay before her. Yeah, so you got this knowledge, man. And nothing else matters, man. You know what I mean? You got the knowledge of Yahweh Hashem outside, true knowledge of Yahweh Hashem outside. Everything, and that's carnal stuff, man. Gold and silver, that's carnal, man. This is spiritual right here, man. Matter of fact, I'm going to, let's see. Let me get this real quick. Got 7 Corinthians. Yeah, kind of. This is on 2 Corinthians. I mean, yeah, 2 Corinthians 4 and 18. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. Yeah, so temporal, that's not nothing compared to eternal, man. Temporal is just for a short period. Yeah, you know I mean? Gold, yeah, okay, it's gold. You know what I mean? But the wisdom is not going to vanish, man. You know what I mean? That's a forever thing. You know what I mean? That's an eternal thing. We're looking at the things that are eternal, man. Lord, are we going through this hell? Nah, man. The Lord is getting away from this carnality. You go through hell, but the Lord is getting you away from carnality, man. You know what I mean? You know? Let's see. And man, there's a lot of scriptures going into wisdom, man. Let's see. This is on verse 14. Just gonna jump around a little bit. You can read the whole chapter, man. With Messiah in the 6th chapter, 7th chapter. The whole book of wisdom, Messiah, but you know, like the 8th chapter. You know what I mean? The 8th chapter going to wisdom. You know what I mean? But I'm just gonna jump down to it. Let me see. Verse 14. For she is a treasure unto men that never faileth, which they use become the friends of the Most High, which being commended for the gifts that come from learning. Yes, sir. You get wisdom, man. You're going to be a friend of the Lord, man. You know what I mean? Let's see. I think I'm going to pull something from the 8th chapter. Let me get something from the 8th chapter. Let's see. This is Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 8. I'm just gonna start at one. Matter of fact, this is Wisdom Sign 81. Wisdom reaches from one end to another mightily, and sweetly though she utter all things. I loved her and saw her out from my youth. I desired to make her my spouse, and I was a lover of her beauty. Yeah, man, because this is your main woman right here, man. Wisdom, man, because she gonna take care of you. You know what I mean? It is what it is. You know what I mean? Wisdom gonna take care of you, man. She gonna comfort you. She gonna make sure you straight, man. She gonna get you out of bullshit. You know what I mean? That's your main woman, man. That's what you do. You know? You lay in the bed with her. All of that, man. Be intimate with her. That's how you be intimate with her. You go through the scriptures, man. You know what I mean? You caress her. Flip the pages, whatever you do, man. This is your main woman, man. You know what I mean? It says, in that she is conversing with the Most High, she magnified her nobility. Yeah, the Lord of all things himself loved her. So, Wisdom Psalm 7:28, for the Most High loved none but him that dwelleth with wisdom, man. You know what I mean? You know, I'm going to get one more precept, man. Let's see. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is this is what I wanted to get. This is on Wisdom Solomon 7. I mean, it's like Wisdom Solomon 8 and 7. And if a man love righteousness, her labors are virtuous, for she teaches temperance and prudence, justice and fortitude, which are such things as men can have nothing more profitable in their life. Yeah, man. If a man desire much experience, she know things of old, and conjure up aright what is to come, and she know the subtleties of speeches, and can expound dark sentences. For she foreseeth signs and wonders, and the events of seasons and times. Cleave on the wisdom, man. I mean, cleave on the wisdom. Tell you, gonna teach you temperance, prudence. You're gonna be wise, man. Justice, fortitude. You're gonna be strengthened, man. You're gonna have strength, man. Yeah, I mean, it says men can have nothing more profitable in their life, man. So this is something that, yeah, I mean, you need this, man. Basically, we need wisdom, man. So once we get it, yeah, I mean, we gotta cleave on to it. You know, the wisdom and knowledge of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, these scriptures, let's say, hold fast what thou hast, man. Let no man take your crown, because when you hold it and you endure it, you're gonna have a crown, man. Yeah, I was sad. Yeah, I mean, it feels good, crown, man. You know what I mean? But Aki, man, hope to edify. Until next time, I'm gonna say shalom.